From WMHS, this is Monticello Today with Michael Comer and Lauren Drake, live from the studio at Monticello High School.
Well, Lauren, last night was certainly an exciting night in the gym here at Monticello.
Look, if you had one shot, one opportunity to seize everything you ever wanted, one moment that you captured, just let it slip. Yo, his palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy, there's vomit.
How's everybody doing tonight? I can't hear you. How is everybody tonight?
We are the Monticello Mustangs. Maniacs. And we would like to induct into the fraternity of Mustang Maniacs next year's class. Hailing from Charlottesville, Virginia. Brody Phillips. Yeah! Also hailing from Charlottesville, Virginia, at 6'1", Sean Burns. Yeah! He may have came from New York, but he's in Charlottesville now. Ryan Jacobson. He's going to be the star of the football team next year. Might even play quarterback, Zach DiGregorio.
Thank you, Mom, for raising me who I am today. Thank you!
Fun was definitely had by all last night, but as Michael mentioned earlier, Caroline will have a full recap later on.
And also still to come this morning, we have details to share with you on Jaleel Mosley and Sam Marshall's big signing day that took place yesterday, so stay tuned for that.
All right, there's a lot of announcements to come right after this.
ASVAB testing will take place on Wednesday, February 13th at 9:40 in the Red Lab. You must sign up outside of P105 by Friday, February 8th if you intend on testing on the 13th. See Ms. Neal if you have any questions. While the pit band auditions for the musical are fast approaching, auditions will take place on February 11th after school in the band room. If you are an instrumentalist and are interested in performing in this ensemble or have any questions, stop by the band room to sign up for an audition time. And don't forget, Friday will be a club day. If you are unsure of what club you belong to, please check the roster posted in the cafeteria. If you are not part of a club, please go to the first block class right after mentorship. See Ms. Nichols with any questions. And now, here's Lauren with more.
Thanks, Michael. College-bound seniors are encouraged to attend Super Saturday from this Saturday from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. at PVCC. This is a great opportunity to receive free one-on-one assistance in completing the FAFSA. Details can be found on the MHS homepage. See your school counselor with any questions. If you plan on auditioning for this year's talent show, today after school is the last day that you can do so. If interested, stop by P205. Also this morning, you are encouraged to support No Name Calling Week this week. Join the Monticello Prevention Group on Thursday morning from 8:30 to 9:30 to create a t-shirt to raise awareness about the hurtful effects of name calling, slurs, and put downs. If you can't make it in the morning, a table will be set up during all three lunches for you to design your own t-shirt. You can supply your t-shirt or pre-order a plain white t-shirt by bringing $2.50 to Taylor Collier during all three lunches on Wednesday. They will supply the fabric markers. Don't forget to wear your t-shirt on Friday to support No Name Calling Week. And with that, we're done from the news desk this morning. The sports report is up next. Stay tuned.
Good morning. I'm Caroline filling in for Thomas while he's away. There's a lot of talk about when it comes to the Mustangs' performance on the court last night. Although, we are going to start today's sports report by rewinding to yesterday when Jahlil Mosley and Sam Marshall signed to play college football next year. Michael has the full story.
Most high school athletes dream of playing in college, but making it to that next level is a feat that only few accomplish. Yesterday, Monticello football standouts Jahlil Mosley and Sam Marshall signed to play football next year at the College of William & Mary. Sam and Jahlil alleviated all of their decision-making stress yesterday, and to celebrate, these two newly minted William & Mary football players chose to spend the exciting time with friends and family. And of course, as with every event here at Monticello, a feast.
I'm not going to lie, the coaching staff and the changes down at JMU, they had something to do with it. I mean, the coaches from William & Mary, they was just there on a day-to-day basis. I mean, I talked to them every day, whether that was on the phone, Facebook. I mean, I just grew a big relationship with them.
We've been talking about it for a while now. It just took him a little while to change his mind, so I waited for him.
Last night, both the boys and girls basketball teams knocked off Fluvanna on their way to the district tournament. The girls won easily by a score of 57-21. The boys' game, however, was a little closer. They won 72-60. Here's a look at some of the action. We'll have more details on the upcoming postseason games tomorrow morning. So for now, thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you tomorrow for another edition of Monticello Today.